liquidate 3.4 billion of its crypto assets due to their bankruptcy. FTX illegally siphoned money from customer accounts to finance risky leverage trading, bets by Alameda. And the ex-girlfriend of SBF, Caroline Ellison, is found crying in court. Direct result of Sam Bankman-Fried, 31, criticizing his girlfriend doing so, which is very cold, callous, and shows the true nature of this particular guy. Of course, throughout social media, there's been a lot of drama over several months, an entire year, and affects the whole crypto space. Talks about a clash with Sam Trobuku, who's new to me in this saga, member of Inner Circle, CEO at Alameda. So this would be what's come out in the court. She was claustrophobic. So obviously a lot of psychological happenings, mental health deterioration, probably due to the realization of what to the size of what they're doing, that they've probably not been able to, not just probably but exactly can't get away with it because of the courts not putting up with it anymore. And it's headline news across various news outlets. FTX court approval to sell the crypto assets. So this is gonna be big news for whether we can, in the crypto space, have exchanges we can trust. It is a big trust issue if they're going to be operating behind use of SPACs. This is never a good thing and very questionable. Promotes the lack of a adoption that puts people away. And that creates a bad image for crypto. But they've definitely got this permission to liquidate the crypto assets, not giving it back to the users. So that would be Solana, Bitcoin and Ether. And it says the total amount. There could be more legalities in place which would make it a bit more or less, but it's still a huge number. And filing for bankruptcy because of their scheme to illegally siphon money. This is obviously so outrageous. It's been an outrageous story for, should not be repeated, but other exchanges we've heard about this week, including CoinEx crypto exchange hits hackers. So there's all kinds of reasons for mistrust in crypto exchanges, their vulnerabilities, not just from social engineering and people doing deliberate FTX like scams, but also hackers who are trying to trick you out of money too. So thanks for listening to this video. Like, share, comment, retweet if you're on Twitter, and if you're on other platforms, you know what to do. Like and share, comment, and have a great day.